Chief Executive Officer of the Ontario SPCA. We welcome you here this morning. Feels like a second home. You sort of look into the audience and see folks like Linda Weir here. Good morning. How good to see you. And Rob Napier, folks who led the helm and the charge to help us build this new facility. As you'll recall, we opened in November of 2011. The place still looks great. Congratulations to staff and volunteers. It looks just like the day that it opened. Today we've got some special guests that we are welcoming, and I think many of you have already said hello. It's a real treat for us to once again have the public support of both Mrs. Harper and Mr. Clement. I'd like to take a minute and just introduce our Member of Parliament, the Honourable Tony Clement, whom I'm sure you know well, and in his history in our government has been both the Minister of Health and the Minister of Industry. Currently serves as the President of the Treasury Board of Canada and has been the Member of Parliament for Parry Sound Muskoka since 2006, a tremendous commitment to public service. So without further ado, I will turn it over to Mr. Tony Clement.
Well, thank you so much, Kate, and welcome everybody. It's great to see a great Muskoka welcome for our special guest. I too want to acknowledge the team here, if I might. Kate, of course, is the CEO, Tom Stevenson, CFO, Kevin McKenzie, Development Manager, Tanya Martin, Senior Manager of Animal Welfare, Judy Cannon, Central Regional Manager, Allison Cross, Director of Marketing and Communications. Jane McCamus is here, Muskoka Branch Manager, of course. Jane is touring around with us. And all of the team that are part of the Branch Animal Care team, who I think they, I'm told, started at 6 a.m. to get everything ready in preparation for our visit. And of course, Brock Napier, who has obviously illustrated how much of a supporter, long-term supporter he is for what is going on here. It's my pleasure to, as Member of Parliament for Parry Sound Muskoka, to welcome Mrs. Harper here. And before I do the official welcome, we usually, when we have visiting dignitaries, we usually give a gift to that dignitary to make it a true Muskoka welcome. Mrs. Harper, in this case, had asked me to make a contribution to the Muskoka SPCA, so I'd like to offer this check to you, Kate, about $400. Ladies and gentlemen, I have the difficult responsibility of introducing a person who doesn't need any introduction, but I want to officially welcome Mrs. Harper here, of course, at this wonderful facility. She has taken 2 days out of her busy schedule to be here in Muskoka to celebrate one of the things that makes Muskoka special, and that's our volunteers. We have so many volunteers doing so many things in so many different areas that help our kids, that help our communities, that help our four-legged friends, and everything in between. And she has shown her commitment. She is a public figure. That's when you're the spouse of a prime minister, it kind of comes with the territory. And she has decided to express that in ways that really do celebrate the wonderful heritage and history and tradition of volunteerism across this nation. So we're having a great time just saying thank you to everyone in Muskoka who does take time out to volunteer for something, and especially here, of course, with the SPCA, we know how much of a difference you make for animal welfare, but by doing so, you're also part of people welfare. We really do consider that. So without further ado, may I introduce to you Mrs. Lorraine Harper.
Welcome. I've got cat fur. Thank you very much. And what a lovely facility, Kate. It's wonderful to be able to come here and see this wonderful, wonderful facility. I love going to humane societies across the country. Humane societies have one of the biggest volunteer bases of any organization. across Canada. They've got hundreds of volunteers to do all sorts of different, no matter what you want to do, walk dogs, look after cats, bring another. They said they had some pigs in here earlier. You never know, every day, you never know what's coming through the door, and it doesn't matter what kind of animal, whether it's a pig or a Degu or cats, litters of kittens which show up every spring. The folks here welcome those animals and take care of them and find them great homes. Now this morning we met a nice little cat named Destiny, about 5 years old. So our goal this week is to get Destiny home. She's been here since June. She's a very friendly animal. So if you know anybody, I think she'd be a good apartment cat or something like that. She's a loves to snuggle. So if you know anybody especially maybe an older person, their animal has died and they're a bit lonely, Destiny, I think, would make a great indoor cat to sit and look out at the birds. So that's a lovely cat. So remember, her name's Destiny. So now I think today we're going to give one of the big things when you build a building like this, and I know in Ottawa one of our biggest things was to get the land to put the building. We had a really old building in Ottawa. We needed millions of dollars to raise to move it to a better and bigger location. But here in Muskoka, I heard you guys didn't have to do that because you had a wonderful citizen who decided to donate the land here, which again is the biggest single cost to charities when they have to build a building, is to get the location. But I heard you have an angel in this community named Brock Napier. So if Brock would come up. Now this plaque is going up in the building.
In the building.
So this, you got the rip and grin there? There we go. So this is the plaque that will be up in the building. So everybody that comes here will know how much the people here appreciate what Brock has done and saved a lot of people a lot of money. And you can take that money, you would have had to buy a piece of land and you can save a lot of animals for that, so we really appreciate that. And then in here is another gift, which I think is a replica of that for your home. So you can have a plaque about yourself in your house. So thank you very much, and thank you to all the volunteers and people. Who knows, maybe somebody will be walking around today. You never know, you look at an animal's face, and you know it's your animal, and you never know when that's going to happen to you. It happened to me in an event just like this in Ottawa. Last year we have a little garden party at the where we try to get people to come.